Today we are talking about keyword brainstorming. When I do keyword brainstorming, there's three things that's really important for me. There's getting the words off your mind. So the thing is, when you start, your mind starts working and you think, oh, this keyword is good, I need to remember this. And then it takes space in your head, and if you're like me and it's not too big, it is nice to like keep 100% of your concentration on the task you have in front of you. So I always write it down, use like 5-10 minutes just to write it down, keep the document open, so I can always, if something pops up to my head, I can write it down so it's not in my head. This list you can use as a seed seed list as well. The thing is that when you're going and finding a list before you start with the related keywords and all that, you want to have a list about the subject, maybe from a dictionary or something, but you want to find this dictionary, and that you can use your brainstorming for, because it might be the same as someone naming a dictionary that comes into your mind, or customers searching for this. So it's good to have this seed keyword list. One of my favorite is to have customer brainstorming, which is basically like who are your potential customers, where they're searching from, which kind of task can you help them with, or, and is there something that you would be overlooking, something that you would not see in the beginning, that might be a small niche or something. Without delaying, I think we should head over and do some keyword brainstorming at the computer.
Use keyword brainstorming to get into the right state of mind. It's always good to like just write the words you have in your mind, so you don't like when you begin say, oh, I have to remember different things. It might not be that efficient, there might be other ways of making it much easier, but it's always good to start a few minutes and use some brainstorming. Let's say we were making or finding some keywords for this keyword tool. So you would be like, keyword is a good word, there's like keyword tool, there's keyword research. You see, I'm doing more or less the same here. There might be like keyword lists and all these different kind of things. But you might also go like what many people sometimes forget is to go more like keywords that is like problem solving. So it could be like how to find keyword for pay-per-click. It is how to rank in Google, tip for improving return on investment in AdWord, all these different kind of things. This is nice making a list like this, but don't overdo it. Use a maximum of 10 minutes. 1 minute is also fine.
To find who our customers are, what they're searching for, which task they're trying to solve, where geographic they are, all these different kind of things, I love finding out about that. And that's what we're gonna do now. Let's take our keyword tool as an example. We want to know who searched for our product. First of all, people who are using a keyword tool will be interested in what is the online demand. Which keyword are people searching for? How many are searching? Can you group them in niches? How big are they? How big is the market? And then you want to go down to niche or keyword level and know, can I compete? Can I make it profitable? All these different kind of questions. If you become a bit more specific, we can go to pay-per-click, which is interesting because you need these keywords I need to advertise for, and it's quite cheap to add an extra keyword. So it's really interesting for people using pay-per-click, because if they can add an extra niche where people convert a lot, low cost, it is interesting, obvious for them, because they can make a profit. If you go down to SEO, is also interested in knowing if you put a lot of effort into a niche, or you think there's a demand within some keywords that will convert well, it's interesting to know that and to know who are competing within this niche. So what tasks will the customer be doing that we can help them with? Will it have to do with a keyword tool? The most important task will be sorting, structuring and updating the keyword list. When you have to do with the long tail of keywords, this becomes complicated and a task that you want to do efficient. But most people are not searching, which I would guess is not searching for structuring keyword list. They'd be searching for the task they want to achieve, the goal they want to achieve. And that is basically improving the search engine marketing. It could be improving ranking in Google, it could be improving their return on investment on AdWords or something like that. But you can also look at the tasks. Tasks like Google-related keywords, we all know is a great source of getting keywords. But we also know the hassle of having thousands of spreadsheets and all combining them and deleting duplicated keywords. It takes a huge amount of time. And a tool that helps that is good, and people can save a lot of time with this task. Same if you have like a niche and you have a keyword list and you expand it, and then you come to a time you find out there's maybe three different kind of customers that you want, three different kind of landing pages, or actually they're searching for three different kind of products, but you can identify some of the keywords, some of them goes to one product, some go to the other one. You want to split the keywords, and where would people be searching from when they search for a keyword tool? Most likely they'll be using a computer. One thing is that people into online marketing use a lot of time on their computer. Another thing is that it's a quite complicated task. You need the keyboard, you need to open several browser windows, and that's difficult with a mobile device. But you could use like an iPad or a smartphone to do some research or read on the methods or see some videos, which make good sense. But if you're going to pay for the traffic, you're most likely not going to pay for certain landing pages coming from mobile devices, because the customers can't continue that road. The last part of the keyword brainstorming can be a gold mine. What would people be overlooking that do this kind of keyword research? What would you be overlooking yourself? What would your competitors be overlooking of the demand? And it's interesting, if you can find some niche, you can probably have it for yourself or be really limited to competition. For the keyword tool, you could think about like people who are buying domains. They need, if they do type in domains, they need to know like how many searches is there, is it increasing, decreasing, all these information. They might want to know like new type in domains that they can buy for cheap, or they want to value expensive exclusive domains that they want to know which direction is going, how much people are paying, and they might also want to know like maybe they have like one word, they also want to know the words people are searching after that or combined with it, to get like an idea about which kind of website it could be used for and all these different kind of things. And they might have a different take on it than people who are doing online marketing. You have copywriters that might not be in the process of doing keyword research, which might be other people who are doing that, and they might also have a different take on keyword research. And then we know that a lot of people are scanning, and they're scanning for the exact keywords they're looking for, and therefore copywriters might want to have a look themselves on some specific area. But one thing we forget a lot in online marketing is there's a lot of people doing offline marketing, and they might be using other tools, like for example, they can do focus groups or other things, and they might be missing out that online marketing is unbiased. So it is nice to, even you're not doing online marketing, it's nice to know what is the demand, what are people searching for specific, so you get some details there, and you might be overlooking that. That concludes our keyword brainstorm video. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope that you would comment, tell a little bit about your experience, so we all can enjoy it.